Hello and happy Passover, everybody. Rabbi Andy Markowitz here, and I'm here to give you some tips on how to spice up your Seder, look at parts of the Seder a little bit differently. So, if you want to impress your friends, I'm going to give you some fast facts specifically about the four questions today and what questioning has to do with the Seder at all. So, first let's go through the four questions. So, if we look at the four questions, it actually starts with a question, which is, Ma nishtana halayla hazeh mikol halelot? You probably hear the tune in your head right now, which translates to, why is this night different from all other nights? Great. So then we get to what we normally call the first question, which is, Shebechol halelot anu ochlin chametz umatzah, that on any other night, we would eat something called chametz, which we know is something that's leavened, so like a bread-type product, or matzah, which is a very specific type of bread product that can't have risen. The moisture and the grain can't have been together for longer than 18 minutes before it's baked. But on tonight, we only eat matzah. So that doesn't sound like a question. In fact, that isn't a question. It's an answer to the question that we started with, which is, Ma nishtana halayla hazeh? Why is this night different? So this night is different first and foremost because we eat matzah. We're going to explore why we eat matzah later on in the Seder, but it doesn't seem to be asking a question. It seems to just be stating, we eat matzah. And the second question, of course, or the second answer to Ma nishtana halayla hazeh is, Shebechol halelot anu ochlin, She'ar yirakot, we eat all sorts of yummy veggies, but tonight we eat maror. So we specifically eat bitter herbs. Again, an answer to a question, and that's a question that we're going to answer, or sort of we're going to explore the idea of the answer as to why we eat maror. But that's not actually posing a question. It's answering the question, why is this night different, or really, how is this night different? So then our next question that we find ourselves with, or answer to the question, Ma nishtana, is Shebechol halelot anu matbilin afilu pa'am echad. It's quite a mouthful. And we're asking, why do we on this night, or we're sort of stating, why on this night do we even dip anything twice? Because on most other nights we could dip something or not dip something, but we dip, of course, the karpas, the green vegetable, into salt water, and we dip the maror into the choroset, the bitter herbs, into the sweet apples and grape juice concoction that we love to smear on our matzah. But so why do we even dip twice? Again, it goes through it, and we sort of, later on in the Seder, we confront why we're dipping, what each of those different things we're doing sort of means, but we're not quite there yet. And then finally, the last answer to the question, Ma nishtana, why is this night different, is Shebechol halelot anu ochlin ben yoshvin, we every other night we eat sitting up, o ben mesubin, or sort of leaning, we could like sort of be, have put our feet up. But tonight, we all are mesubin, we are all leaning, we're all sort of relaxed. And why is that the case, is the implicit question. Now, it's interesting that these are implicit questions and not actual questions, because the Seder is supposed to be something different. Now, that's difficult when the Seder is sort of canonized and is the same liturgy that we would use every year, year in and year out. So the Haggadah becomes a liturgical piece that is familiar and is distinctly comforting because it's not different. So I would challenge all of us to actually do something different at our Seders. In fact, if we look at early rabbinic tradition, people would do wacky things during the Seder just to get people to start asking questions. In the Talmud, it's suggested that we throw peanuts and popcorn, which are not kosher for Passover according to Ashkenazi, right? Although this year, by all means, they throw goodies at children in order to get them to ask, wait, why are you throwing this goodie at me? And so to start a conversation about freedom, about being being a free person in today's world and what responsibilities we have and how we can honor our tradition and our past of not being so free. And there are other traditions marked in the Talmud of people actually getting up in the middle of the Seder and moving the actual table that you're eating off of away, and just to sort of the bafflement of the people at, around the Seder, to again, to elicit questions. So my challenge for all of us as we prepare a Seder that is to be different from all other Seders is to lean in to the skid, or steer into the skid a little bit, and to recognize that this Seder is going to be different, and we're going to be asking all sorts of questions. And those questions, that while they might lead to conversation that's outside of the Haggadah itself, that is what the Seder is all about. It is supposed to be a night that is different because we ask some hard questions and we sort of work together to get those answers. And it's not clear that everyone gets the same answer when we look at the four children. But it, ultimately, it's supposed to be a night that is different. It's supposed to be a night in which we act a little kooky and we step out of our comfort zone in order to elicit conversation and meaningful debate. So, b'hatzlacha, good luck to everyone with their Seder, and I hope you do something a little kooky in order to elicit a little more question-making. Have a Chag Sameach. There can be me.